Like Haiti over here, you got a little cheap hole running around chasing Haiti.
Hey, man, I ain't mad at doing anything for reason, man. It ain't here to be a reason, but you know, damn life.
Speaking about your life, tell us about your new project.
Man, I'm actually working on Mixtape Maniac 3, my new return. Man, got some fine features, man. I got some features from something from the point. Got that dude, got T-Bone Skin, got my boy Sino on him. And it's nice, man. I've been actually working on it for a while, and this is gonna be one, I think it's gonna be one of my favorite, one of my best projects ever, man.
Okay, and now, why do you feel so confident about this particular project?
Man, it's been a long time coming. I've been working on this for, I want to say, at least about 2 years. And, I changed my perspective on it quite a few times. But I chose the point of return because I feel like now, I'm at the point of my music career that I can't turn back now. People know me. People looking for me. Be ready. When you dropping this? Be ready when you dropping this? Because I'm doing stuff that nobody else is doing. I'm doing stuff that nobody else in this area is doing. None of the other local artists are really putting out videos. Nobody else are doing interviews. Like, all they're doing is putting out music, putting out songs, and they're working their butts off for what? One song. We putting stuff out here. Me and the point, we're doing stuff. We're doing stuff that nobody else is doing.
Okay, so can you tell me exactly within this particular mixtape, what makes this mixtape special and unique from all the other ones you already put out in the past?
Well, see, a lot of the other ones, man, it was just like, give me a beat. Okay, you play that song? Okay, I'm a rapper. Oh, you like that beat? Oh, I'm a rapper. But see, with this one, I actually took, this is the first mixtape, the first CD I ever sat down and actually bought beats. I actually said, hey, I'll actually sit down and work with producers, and I was like, man, I want to do something. You know what I'm saying? I want to do this. I'm not just going to rap on it, just blah, 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 freestyle. Like, I actually worked on it. It's the first album I ever did that for. And I feel like that's what sets it.
Okay, so do you feel like, as an artist, you're finally really coming into your own? You're finally, like, really fulfilling your true artistry?
I think that's the best way to describe it. I think that's, like, that is perfect. That's perfect. Because that's the way I want the media and the way I want the fans to perceive it as. That's what I mean when I say the point of return. I'm here now. I'm here. It's no time to turn back. I'm here. It's time for me to embrace myself as an artist. You know? People look at me and they're like, be right, oh yeah, you drunk, you drinking, you alcoholic, you do this shit. Yeah, I do it. But you know what? I put it on music. I put that in my music because when I put it in my music, I still feel that pain. Even though I might be a user, an abuser or whatever, I still have pain. You know what I'm saying? Like, I make songs about, being broke. We might all be broke. Hey. People live check to check. People want to hear that. If you're broke and you don't have any money, you're not balling like that. Why do you want to hear about you trying to move out or something like that? Do you want to hear that? I mean, it sounds good on the beat. It sounds good on the beat, but
in reality, we all in that lifestyle.
Exactly, but you know, when people spit something that you can relate to, you tend to like it more. You know, if somebody sit there and you're talking about how you working a 9-to-5, struggling trying to survive, you feel them more. You come more close in contact with them, and that's what I'm trying to do with my music. I'm trying to come close in contact with them. I mean, I could take the easy way out. And I could lie like all these other rappers do. I could, oh, I'm driving this, I'm doing this. I can take the route, but I'm not. What I want to do is give them the truth. You know? Okay. Nobody else want to do that.
Okay, so obviously you feel that your music is extremely relatable to your target audience, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so is that, what type of audience are you trying to target specifically?
I'm trying to target everyone. But it's seems like the more that I am connected to, the more that I'm connected with, are the people who struggle, the people who out here just barely make it. The people who out here, you know, they working, they taking care of their home, you know. Wayne said he ain't got no worries. Everybody got worries. Everybody got worries. I don't care if you're rich in the world, Bill Gates got worries. Everybody got worries.
I'm worried about this car note that's been in two more days, man.
Hey, brother. You know we all got working, man. I like when I rap about that. When I rap about that, the song, he's like, man, my car note do this one too.
Oh, man.
Hey, you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. You know, man. He know, he feel me, you know. And I mean, that's what I'm trying to talk about. Remember what you're trying to say is, coming to the commercialization of music. Commercialization, and I mean, I'm trying to be right. But I mean, at the same time, there's a thin line between being commercial and selling out.
Yeah, yes, see, however, there still is a balance if you choose to take that route.
And
look at it, look at Lil Wayne is very commercial. I mean, he collaborates with like anyone from the country genre, pop, R&B, rap, indie music. He collaborates with
everybody. And think about it, I don't want to compare myself to Wayne because I'm not Dwayne. Wayne's one of the greatest of all time. Okay. Wayne, you know, with Tupac and Biggie and all that. But I feel like my music is, like, compared to local rap, compared to underground rap, compared to everybody else you can compare me to,
mm-hmm.
I'm first.
You're right. Why did you choose the music route?
Why music? Music has always been a passion for me, bro. Like, ever since I could remember, man, it's always been music. Always been music.
Okay, so like, what initiated that passion? What sparked that flame in you? So like, hey, I really, really want to pursue this as a career or as a profession.
Man. Actually, it wasn't sparked as a professional career, but actually, when I think about what inspired me to rap, it was the No Limits. It was the Cash Money. Because No Limit and Cash Money and Randy, maybe because I'm Southern, maybe because I'm Louisiana, I don't know. But No Limit, I remember they would always have a CD coming out every month. They will always have an artist from No Limit Records dropping something every month. And that's what I want to point to be. That's why I got artists all the point. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get R&B artists, rap artists, everything. Because every month, I remember when I was a kid, I would go to the mall, my mom would go to the mall, and I would get a pair of Jordans and a No Limit CD. I'm good. That's what I would do. I would go to the mall, pair of Jordans, No Limit CD, jam No Limit CD on the way home. That was it. I loved it. And that's what got me on the rap. But it really was R&B that got me
there. You know what I mean? Okay, so are you basically trying to tell me that you are starting to develop an interest in R&B?
Man, starting to develop. I mean, I feel like I was always an R&B character. I mean, but I grew to accept that I don't have an R&B voice. I don't have an R&B voice. I don't have a basic voice. But at the same time, I can write.
Okay.
I know I can. It was something like R. Kelly, man. It got me going, man. I mean, man, all of this was awesome. Man, my first CD I bought was R. Kelly. The R. Kelly CD.
Which one? 12
play? That's 12 play. I had 12 play on cassette.
Okay.
And then he also don't remember my cassettes, man. We had cassettes back in the day. But,
way back in the day.
Yeah, way back in the day. But, the first CD I got, the R. Kelly, the one with the one, you know, the one with the
song. You remind me of my G. I wanna ride it, something like my sound.
That was my stuff. That was my first thing I ever had, man. First thing I ever had. You know what? What I can say about R. Kelly, man. R. Kelly messed my life up, man. I blame R. Kelly, man, because all I heard when I was young was down low. I heard all this. So that's all I knew.
Just keep on download. Okay.
I was messing with Mr. Big's girl. Yeah, that download. Messing with Mr. Big's girl download.
Oh yeah, man. Next week, you are starting to develop this interest in R&B and actually starting to pursue possibly singing on some of your tracks?
Yeah, man. Actually, I'm doing the singing on a couple of my songs. Not no big sound singing.
Okay.
And definitely not any auto-tune. Auto-tune, okay. I can't stand auto-tune. I mean, big up to everybody who's auto-tune. Big up to everybody. I mean, you know, Future, what's up, T-Kanye, what's up, what's up.
Yeah.
But that's not me. If I can't sing it, I'm like, okay.
Okay, well, to me personally, I thought you just threw a little shade towards, you know, T-Pain and Future.
I mean,
take it.
You don't want to take it like that. You don't see Drake? I was going to do it.
True.
Oh.
Okay, so what's your favorite track that you are actually singing on your new music?
My favorite song off the new album? Man. But I would have to say my favorite song.
With you singing on it.
With me actually singing?
Yes.
With me singing, okay. I'm not really a bit too much over singing, but I love Shooting Stars. I mean Shooting Stars was, you know,
earlier on in the interview, you mentioned your particular group, The Point.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I have a question for you. You know, a lot of people out here may say, you know, your sound's very local, very, you know, country. Is that what you do have to say to those particular people who feel that way about your music?
Man, that's me. It's country rap tunes. It's like the great country there. Rest in peace, man. Country. It's country rap tunes. That's how we rap out here. I mean, you got people up north, up East Coast, they rap their certain way.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people in the Midwest, they rap their certain way. West Coast. You know, man, you got the West Coast, like, everybody out there, they rap their certain way. This is how we do it. And this is how I do it out here. And I feel like I am one of the pioneers of the Southern movement.
In this particular region?
Yeah. Oh, definitely. Yeah. Definitely.
Okay. You know, I'm trying to push any buttons. I'm just trying to clarify for the fans that could be looking at this now.
Think about
Do you feel that you are considered a pioneer in the Nagash area for music?
Man, look, I've been doing this so long here in Nagash, man. And I mean, people look up to me. They know they look up to me and they look at me as a vet. They know I've been doing it for so long. They know when it comes to music, who to come to. Because when they know they come to me, I'm going to give them a hit. You can either have a hit hook, you can have a verse, you can have something. But anytime I come on now, you already know that song is worth videoing.